Hello, YouTubers. You are joining a new talk show that has it all. She's got style. She's got flair. She's the answer to all of your problems. She's not afraid of anything. She's not afraid to shine, and she is here for you. You're joining her once again in a brand new season of her talk show, where she will be talking about introduction, talk topic, answering questions from Google, and many, many more, including a brand new segment that has been replaced with Song of the Day, which is now Question of the Day, until further notice or until change is announced. Join her today because she is not afraid to shine. More importantly, there's the people's thoughts. Just make sure you're throwing in those comments and hoping to be there to promote her show of the Beauty Your Life of LadyTAngel. She wants to thank you for joining her once again. Her real name is Taylor Shanice Raymond. Hey, what up, YouTubers? Hey, thank you guys so much once again for joining me here on my talk show, The Beauty of Your Life with LadyTAngel, yours truly. That would be me. Yeah, thank you guys so much once again for being here with me today. Okay, 4 more episodes after this one, and then we are completely done with season 3 already, and can't believe how fast this process is going. We are up to episode 20 now as we just so speak. So, the title of this episode is called Steps of Success. And at this episode, you will officially see information, official pictures, and more of season 4. So, get psyched. Okay, some you'll be expecting to see on my Twitter page. Once again, find me there. GorgeousAdvice_. It'll be in the description below for you guys also, if you guys do not remember. But I don't have to really put it in the description, really. All you have to do is go to my homepage here on YouTube. I mean, you guys know what the link is. It's right there. Just click on that little, bird in the blue box. And then that's my Twitter page right there. Okay, and some will also be on my Instagram. I just created not too long ago. My Instagram name is Lady_T_Angel_World. That's it. I mean, I don't know how many underscores is that. Okay, LadyTAngel_World. Oh, that's only 3 underscores. But find me there on my Instagram. I just created not too long ago. I could really use some followers on there also. But I God bless you guys once again for giving me over 30,000 followers. I really appreciate you guys taking the time to follow my page. I really do. But if you ever want to sub back from me on my channel here, just let me know. I will take a look at your page and I will sub back to you, as well as if you mention me on Twitter for a follow back, because I follow like so many people, as well as so many people follow me. I'll still be able to recognize you guys, and I'll follow you back on there also. Just let me know. Okay, but Steps of Success is the name of this episode. And before we get it started, I would like to show you guys what I'm wearing for this episode today. I mean, it's not really festive. It's like kind of old stylish, but I mean, I still think it's kind of cute. I mean, it's kind of like a attached scarf over an undershirt, really. That's really what it is, in my opinion. But if you guys have a better name for it, that's what the people stars are for. Just make sure you're throwing in those comments. No hashtag necessary for that one. I mean, the pants ain't nothing. I mean, I had these pants for a minute. I mean, the shirt is new, though. Okay. Now, the real reason why we are here today. Okay, and this question is provided by Google, not by me. And the question is, how can the make of money define your life? So that is real easy. Okay, I believe we talked about this in previous episodes, but I'm going to explain it to you guys again and try to sum it up. The way that, how can I put this? Okay, the way that the make of money can define your life can do a lot, because nowadays the world, the universe is all about money. So just remember that and keep that in mind. It's all about money. And especially like the things that you're doing, if you're just like a lucky person that stays at home, being on your ass all day, and just go to the casino from time to time or play a lottery from time to time, you come off lucky as hell. I mean, sure, that could define your life also. I mean, and also going to PCH and all of that stuff. I mean, again, if you guys don't remember what that is, it stands for Publishers Clearing Houses. I mean, they have a website and they're on TV, and they're on TV all the goddamn time. I don't remember one time that I ever watched a TV show and I see a commercial like, oh, it's PCH. I see that every single day. So they're everywhere. I guess they're very popular like that, or they're just desperate to get more people to play their games and all of that, and believe that they come out a winner. Not everybody can be a winner. Shoot, only one in 1 million can be one. I ain't never seen nobody close to me ever come off that lucky. That's why we got jobs. Because I gave up my PCH a long time ago. No joy for me at all. But yeah, the make of money can have a huge impact on your life. I mean, the number one thing that people do, especially when all else fails, like what I was mentioning before or anything else like that. Like I said, if you feel like there's something was missing, that's where people start support. Just make sure you're throwing those comments and let me know what's up. Okay, what was I trying to say here? Well, sorry about that, but yes, the number one thing that people do to make money or keep money in their pockets is buy a job. Sure, I got myself into one too, even though I'm a lazy ass. I wish I could just sell my ass all day and just get free money, but shoot, money don't grow on trees. I mean, technically it does, but you can't get it for free. But like for example, I have an older brother that works for the post office. I mean, he leases new cars every 2 years. He has the perfect house, the perfect family. I mean, his house look better than the ones I was living in back when I was a child. And he's been working for the post office for over 10 years, and he's doing better than my mother ever has. She's been working for retail stores for the longest, and she's still doing that now. I mean, but he's doing way better than my mother has ever did in her life. And she's very proud of him. She's hoping that everybody else, I mean, other children, including me, would go down the same path. I mean, especially with the mistakes that we make, we had no choice but to wait until we get a sign that says go for it and wait until things gets better. Now, because like for example, I'm owing court costs and stuff right now. I mean, even though it's embarrassing to reveal, so until I get all of that out the way. So it's for traffic tickets, it's nothing big. But until I get all of that out the way, I won't be able to have my own place. And like I probably mentioned beforehand, but if I haven't, here it goes. I had a Dodge Neon for about 4 years, but when I handed the car over to my boyfriend Nathaniel, it got wrecked by someone that was driving drunk and riding down the street. It happened when I was working late night at work, and the police had ended up calling me, telling me what happened. The car was on the side of the street, but yet it still got hit. The guy claims that he was drunk and he didn't see it, but he has a new car, not even 6 months old. Oh my god damn it! It's like my life is just it's just going down the drain. I mean, nobody was in the car, nobody got hurt, thankfully, and more importantly, so the guy is completely at fault because the car was in park. It has not moved. It was standing in one place. It was right in front of my boyfriend's house, and this happened when I was at work, like I just mentioned before. But Yeah, I'm trying to get my car together also, which is making it more difficult because I'm taking care of everything else and making sure I stay up on my feet, making sure I keep the job that I have now, even though it doesn't pay me enough, give me enough hours, or the conditions of doing customer service up at that place. Mate, trust me, it's like complete hell doing customer service for that job. You do not want to go there. But yeah, I'm basically just trying to get my life together. As an example, I'm providing to you guys, but I'm pretty sure some of you, if not most of you, are doing way better than I am. Just please never get into trouble. Sure, because that could wreck your life in ways that you possibly will never understand. Sure, I'm basically trying to get myself together. And like a long time ago, I was saving up for an apartment and everything, back before my car even got wrecked, and then before this court shit came up. Now I'm back to square one. Starting over, got back in with my mother, and making sure once I get this out the way that I'll be okay and I'll be able to be back on my own. But as for the rest of you, I wish you all the best of luck out there, and I hope you guys are doing very well. That's my hospitality to you. I hope you're doing very well. But that's an example. I mean, money can have a huge impact on your life depending on what you're doing, where you're working, and well, that's basically it. I forgot to say "and" right after that one. I don't know why. But anyway, YouTubers, that will be the end of this episode. And once again, thank you guys so much once again for joining me. I apologize about the awkward silences again. It's just I've been thinking about so much, and so much has been happening. It's just unbearable. You guys have no idea. You guys don't want to be in my shoes or be in my position right now. I'm just sharing it. I was just putting out an example out there for you guys. But I hope you're doing way better than I am right now. But that's the end of the episode, YouTubers. Just make sure you're replying to the people's thoughts, like I mentioned before. And make sure the hashtag for question of the day, which I'm about to mention to you guys right now. Okay, your QOTD challenge for this episode will be. What is the rate that your job pays you? What's your occupation, and what kind of things do you do with your money? That's your QOTD challenge for this episode. I'm sorry, I'm suddenly being tongue twisted right now. It's just funny, but that's your QOTD challenge. I'm sorry. Okay, let me go ahead and get off here before I mess something else up. Okay, well, God bless you, YouTubers, and I'll catch you guys later on in another episode, and I look forward to seeing you guys soon in season 4, which is coming up September 18th. Looking forward, and I hope you guys catch my interview that's coming up before season 4 is up on my page. I'm real excited about that also, and you guys will also see my new look in the interview for that extra. So make sure you're sharing with your buddies, and just make sure you keep updated. Deuces.